Day four.
When we're finally going to Ubud. Nasi goreng shirt. We got it from this store we just walked by in Chengdu. I think we got ripped off, but yeah, we got ripped off, but it's cute.
She wouldn't hassle.
She wouldn't haggle.
I was a hassle, she wouldn't haggle. She was too good.
You're being a pain. But she was really nice.
Really?
Looks like they serve more lunch dishes. We were expecting like brunch food, but
yeah.
Oh well.
This works.
This is fine too. They've got pizza, pasta, and Indonesian dishes. We ordered the mee goreng. It comes with a fried egg, some vegetables, crackers, and this chili, which Brian just tasted and he's dying right now.
Chili.
How good does the noodle look? Yum.
It smells really good though. Very fragrant.
It smells amazing. And I don't know how to pronounce this, but this is the ayam penyet. It is a spicy chicken leg with sambal and rice. Brian tasted this sambal after he ate that chili. This one here. And now he's dying as well.
That's also pretty chili. Sure.
You didn't learn your lesson.
That's pretty good.
The flavor's so good. It has that that stir fry flavor. So nice.
Yum.
Let me try the chili. I think I die as well.
She gonna die. Eat it with the noodles. GG. It's over. It's over. It's over. It's over. See ya. Oh, let's try the chicken.
Is the chicken dry?
It's not too bad.
How's the sambal compared to the other knife?
The other knife was better, but this is just like a different color. Very fragrant. Color like green. Not too chilly.
Okay. This chicken is actually so fragrant. It's like banana leaves. Does it taste like that?
I don't know.
This sambal is spicy. I don't know what Brian was talking about, but spicy. Brian's upset that I ate all the egg yolk.
I got some.
Delicious, right?
That's how about put in your emptiness.
We met a really awesome Gojek driver named Joe, so we let him take us around for half the day. We wanted to try some of Bali's exotic fruits, so he took us to his mom's fruit shop where we could try some and support the family business.
It's same thing or not? Different.
Different.
Really?
Yes. More bitter, but a little bit sour. Yeah, like
Which one's sweet?
Sweet too.
Oh, sweet too. Oh, okay. Yeah.
Where we learned how these traditional Indonesian cloths are made and how much work goes into creating such intricate patterns and details for these beautiful fabrics. Lemongrass, ginger, turmeric, green tea, red ginger tea, and then we've got a few coffees. There's ginseng, Bali, vanilla, Bali cocoa, coconut coffee. Oh my god, I can't wait. This is the complete plate, which had all different kinds of meats, and it's served with rice and some soup. We really just wanted to try this and love it. Oh, I see some fat. Meat. I hope it's super crispy. Apparently this place is a little pricier, but the babi guling is really good. And this was only $7. Guys, this pork is absolutely delicious. Oh my god. It's so so juicy, so moist, packed with so much flavor. I feel like it's soaked up all the juices. Oh, so good. Try it.
What, the whole thing?
No, the whole thing. I had the whole piece. What do you think?
I thought it'd be more milk in your mouth. But it's good.
Really damn. Nice and salty. These are real high standards. It was so juicy. Oh, so good. Let's try the other meats. I think that's this here is the sausage. Right?
There's two sausages maybe. This is a, one of the sausages. Juicy.
Crispy. Is that a skin?
Mm-hmm.
You know what it tastes like? It tastes like KFC chicken skin, but like times 10 the flavor. It's so crunchy. The flavor is really good. And the juices are so cheap. This is only $1.80 each, and I can't believe it. We pay like $6 for this back at home each. But anyway, this is a mango juice. This is a watermelon juice. Mango juices here are crazy. They're so good. We had a fresh one at our driver's family market. And they were nice enough to cut it up and let us try it. And it was so good. We made a quick stop at the Ubud Art Market, and the one thing that caught our attention were these paintings, and they were absolutely stunning. Second villa in Ubud, and it looks crazy inside. Let me show you guys. Can you see the pool? Get a view of the rice. Can you believe that this entire villa is about $50 per person per night? From afar it looks pretty simple, but holy crap, look at all of this detail.
I'm assuming all of this is made of wood because
inside. Big spacious bed. Got a little welcome note here. I'll open that and read that letter later.
Huge room.
Just look at the scale of this room. So big, and there's really high ceilings, so it makes it feel even bigger. They've given us a bowl of welcome fruit. Can't wait to try all these. There's snake fruit, which is what we tried at the fruit shop earlier, and then I honestly don't know anything else other than bananas, of course, but super exotic.
Wait. There's a
but that came included with our stay because we did request a flower bath. Welcome to our home at Ganeca Wooden Villas. It's our pleasure to have you to stay with us. Thank you for choosing our cottage and I trust you will enjoy your stay at our home. Thank you.
This fork was used by Merlin back in 1872. It's got a built-in wand.
That's fact-checked.
Yeah, just trust.
Always. What else is there?
Anyway, this wand is the twin brother. It's the same style, but it's a spoon.
A spoon wand?
Yep. And the knife.
This one?
The knife looks pretty cool.
Don't cut yourself.
I'm too sharp.
After dinner, we did a little magic reading and checked out the magic shop downstairs. And that is a wrap for our full-on unexpected day in Ubud, and it was honestly one of the best days we had in Bali. In my next vlog, we'll be chasing Bali's stunning hidden gem waterfalls. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe. I'll see you in my next video.